First, thank you very much for the opportunity of being here with you today with so many friends of this area and many colleagues, and just for the fact of getting to know you all. It is a privilege to be here with you and to be able to give the point of view of Microsoft regarding cybersecurity. So before starting, I wanted to apologize a little bit. I'm going to speak Spanish, but my PowerPoint presentation will be in English. I haven't had the time to translate it. I'm going to introduce myself a little bit more. I represent a group within Microsoft that is called Cybersecurity Solutions Group. Our group is the result of Microsoft working for cybersecurity. Our leader is Satya Nadella, which joined Microsoft nearly 4 years ago, and one of the things that he did was to launch this group. Our focus is quite interesting, and it's part of the reason of why we're a huge company. And we have different business lines, different offers, which really includes a lot of security. Our applications, our CRM applications, we have our cloud, which is called Zure. And ever since this group was created, we are in charge of transmitting the market, the vision, to all that we do regarding the solution, the product, etc. Our responsibility is to take to the market our security message in a consolidated way. So specifically, my responsibility is the business development to Middle East and Africa. So I was said at first, my goal is to share with you our point of view in cybersecurity. It is interesting because our president, Satya Nadella, has it very clear. He says that our goal is to, our goal and our responsibility is to give our customers the safest platform possible. Obviously, because if it's not safe, people will not use it. And that is our main goal in the market. Obviously, we want this platform to be the safest one so our customers can do the work in the best way possible and reach more people with a safe platform. So I'm going to talk to you about the trends from the perspective of a giant. These are many things that we are seeing from Microsoft point of view in the cybersecurity point of view. For example, the customers are going more and more towards one platform, the automatization, which I will talk about in the presentation, but I will especially focus my talk in clarification of cybersecurity, that is, the transformation or how we make more agile the digital transformation with this transformation or migration to cloud.
As a start,
we are seeing that the sector is changing very fast and very radically. We are seeing that the cyberspace is a great, huge battlefield. This is evident for companies, for the political level, and for the individual. And we are also seeing the situation or the lack of capacities that the market has to be able to confront this transformation. What Erin Gardner already talked about. It's quite interesting because in Microsoft we have a global cyber summit.
Global, que es precisamente finales de esta semana,
and that is actually at the end of this week, and the main commentary is how worried they are because they cannot find qualified people. We can talk about this a little further, but basically qualified people in cybersecurity with the new environment that we are finding, that is the main issue. So I do confirm what Gardner has confirmed at this regard. And obviously that everything can be hacked. Everything that is connected is vulnerable to be a victim of hacking. The person, the information, etc.
Regarding
the cybersecurity, it is very interesting to put within context the whole year. Because the data, well, I haven't listened the previous, haven't listened this in the previous presentation, so I don't think I'm repeating anything. But the data are quite surprising. So, for example, there is an attack every 39 seconds. Something that really caught my eye. I don't know if we can see this later in more detail, but things like 75% of the healthcare industry has been infected with malware.
Los trabajos que no cumplidos de seguridad de todo el mundo alcanzarán 3,5 millones.
The works that do not comply with the cybersecurity will reach 3.5 million by 2021,
and
nearly $1 million will be spent in cybersecurity in 2000 between 2017 and 2021. So these data really are surprising, and they should put us within a context. Another thing that I think it's important, although we all know, and it can be a little bit difficult to assimilate, is that the cybercrime has a supply chain and a real platform, a commercial platform that is real. So if someone really wants to attack a company, and if they want to launch a malware or a virus, they can find a way of doing it, finding their vulnerable data or finding some specific personnel, and it's not very difficult. And in fact, there is a list price with all you want to do, and that's easy to find.
The digital state.
So this is the new model that we are finding at this moment. Everything is a sensor, a transceiver, everything is a source of intelligence, and everything is, of course, it's vulnerable and it's potentially a vector attack.
So
drawing radios, it's useless. Probably it's more counterproductive because what we want is to be global and agile. And being able to control this is very difficult. The cloud has redefined what it means to deliver a customer service. It allows fast development according to the needs, adapting to compete, and it has taken us much farther away of those control points that we can predict. The market is very much fragmented, and it's quite confusing for someone that it's new in this environment, and especially for those that have to adapt to the new trends. So this is very interesting because here we can see all the different domains within cybersecurity. It's interesting because we can see the application security of data information, monitoring, detection of threats, identities management, and the governance applications. I have some colleagues in this sector that they always mention that there's always cybersecurity, and the other one says that there is not. But everything is important important to be able to control everything, and each one of these have their own vulnerabilities, their own threats, and their own attacks, risks, and their own skills. What is interesting here is that with all this, we still have more than 150 security controls and more than 500 manufacturers of these. Additionally, our architecture
del mercado, la arquitectura de seguridad aún no está diseñada
para combatir still las amenazas. Not designed to fight all these threats, the modern threats. We recognize
la posibilidad
that many
de
include
innovar,
the possibility of innovation, but in an isolated way.
Y realmente es complicado realmente
and it is actually quite complicated to accumulate or automatize all this security in all these domains.
El cloud service provider en seguridad
the cloud service provider
realmente ya no debe considerarse un stopper.
Should no longer be considered an stopper, an inhibitor to adopt public cloud services. We need new approaches that leverage the characteristics and the advantages that the public clouds allows.
Si esas capacidades se aprovechan adecuadamente,
if these capabilities are properly leveraged, the information will be better protected than those in the data traditional data centers.
Managed security service providers realmente están
the
ahí
managed security
para hacer,
service providers really are there
partner, realmente,
to create a partner for our customers.
Para la seguridad. Aquí realmente quería compartir con vosotros
what I want to share here
una,
with
una
you
real,
it's a real world example that we have found
la seguridad en cloud
and
ha podido parar,
how
pues, ha podido realmente,
the cloud security has been able
realmente interceptar
to
lo que ha podido
intercept
ser, pues, una
which could have been a very huge thing. How many people here got to know about DoFoil? Well, not very many, that's good. So it seems that we did things in an appropriate manner. So on March 6th, the Windows Defender antivirus before noon captured more than 8,000 instances of what seemed a very sophisticated Trojan.
En milisegundos,
what they did in milliseconds, so they could apply the machine learning of the cloud with the capacity
de analizar el comportamiento
of analyzing
de esos sensores que se estaba
the behavior of those sensors that were being received to detect
realmente de los diferentes, las diferentes tipos de troyanos y darse
the different
que
types of Trojans and realize that they really belonged
también
to the DoFoil family. I also have here written down that they were also called smoke loader. And then, in a few seconds, this artificial intelligence was implied to make those signatures to be in a cloud and then being able to stop a threat that could be much worse. So just for you to have some data before 12 hours, more than 400,000 instances were found in less than 12 hours. 75% of these were in Russia. Turkey had an 18% and 4% in the rest of the world.
Entonces realmente obviamente estamos en un entorno donde así
so
como debería de funcionar el así es como funciona el cloud y obviamente sería
that's how the cloud should always work and
local.
This should be very difficult to do it in a local level.
Otro obviamente otro ejemplo
another example
de este caso ha sido el lo que le he llamado en agosto de este mismo año
it's what we
el
had in August of the same year of 2018, what we called the
Ursniff.
So in milliseconds, we have the capacity, or the cloud has the capacity of detecting from sensors at the customer side the anomaly, and then the protection can be extended.
Aquí vemos obviamente el modelo de compartir.
What we see here, it's the model of sharing the responsibility of security. So what we see is the trend that we have already mentioned, that because of the difficulty of managing these big threats and the amount of people needed to be able to do this analysis at a technological level, so what we show here, it's more the possibility of sharing of sharing the responsibility of keeping one safe. So according to a recent report from Gartner, it is calculated that in the next 5 years, 95% of the incidences will be because of the customer or the final user. So this also helps to motivate customers to consider how important it is to do this shifting or sharing with the cloud.
La seguridad realmente, como comentamos, es una tarea conjunta.
So really, security is a task for everyone together between the provider and the customer. Attacks can be avoided, creating a team with the provider, and instead of providing measures, security measures, after the attack has been discovered or a vulnerability has been discovered.
Aquí comparto que son cuatro realmente
what I share here is four core areas that are critical that we should consider to do this transformation or this shift to the cloud. And all of these are quite important. First is the identity as the new perimeter.
El tener una constancia o persistente.
Also having
auditoría de cumplimiento.
A constant compliance monitoring of the information and classification, being all the time monitoring, monitoring in all the domains that we have already mentioned, and obviously being able to have large scale intelligence, but especially to be able to change the operations in based on the information that we have. So we'll get in deeper detail with these four core areas. So regarding the identity, as organizations and their employees are moving to the cloud, the security strategy needs to start with a unique and protected identity. So when we talk about the customers that are migrating to the cloud, we see that they are still worried about the security on the network during the transition. But the reality is that as you move to the cloud, the identity becomes your way of controlling or monitoring. And so, as I mentioned, identity is the new perimeter. As you can see,
as
you could see before, I'm sorry about this, it is very difficult to control all this and the interaction of all this. So, and today it's not very clear where the limits are. So controlling the perimeter is basically useless, as I said before. I'm sorry about the mistake here.
A nivel, existen obviamente las cuatro fases principales.
So we have the four main phases of the protection of information. And the second core area is detect, classify, protect, and monitor. This includes protecting confidential information in devices, in mobility, that everything is in the cloud, and also to be able to do these four things at a local level. The third core area is regarding the operations at the level of operation. As we can see in the bottom line, the previous domains are here. So it is very important to have the capacity of monitoring or controlling and correlate the incidences in each of these domains. And orchestrate the security here, and something that we are seeing more and more, which is automatization. At this level of operation, what we need, and we are seeing this more and more, is a report that can show the summary that allows us to understand the state of the security and also being able to inform or report this at a committee level.
But
additionally to this report and this control or this control panel, there is still the need of maintaining the capacity of human analysis. And obviously at the level of intelligence, as I said before. So the four core areas, I talked about them all together, but probably this could be go in first place, because the fourth core, which is being able to enjoy a big intelligence, we should also have the capacity to change the needs. So from this point of view in Microsoft, we are very proud of having so much information that we can analyze, and also to take all these to the value that we find in our customers. So we are daily analyzing, and we get to analyze 3.5 billion
de sensores de
of instance sensors for threats every day. So 6.5 billion of daily threats. And we analyze this information constantly. So as you can see, we get this information, we get very valuable information. Something very interesting that I heard once at a cooperative level is that Xbox is the most attacked level. So we have the capacity of getting this information and apply this information and to our own solutions. As I already mentioned,
cloud se llama Azure,
our cloud, the name of our cloud is Azure.
Muy orgullosos realmente de dar, de sentirnos como el, la,
and
la
we're very proud
the public cloud,
of being the safest public cloud, or the one that has a greater diversity of tools
implementando
for our customers.
Para clientes y para nosotros mismos. Nos, realmente Microsoft, nosotros funcionamos y trabajamos
so
con
in Microsoft,
cloud,
we work with the same cloud. And we use
a nuestros clientes.
The same tools and the
nosotros
same measurements that we offer our customers. We have
no
a very
si
big network of partners, and I think it was nearly 1 month ago, our event for customers, we launched a great amount of very interesting information, like having an international sharing area for our partners. That way our technological partners can have the intelligence alerts at the same time that we are launching them. And this was started very recently.
We
apply our own measures of application governance, best practices, architecture, developers, application equipment, and obviously the life cycles at the level of management service. I have very little time, but I would have. But I would really was interested of spending some more time in that area. I hope that I have transmitted well the information. We believe that the biggest trend is the change we are seeing little by little in different areas or that we are implementing for this cloud migration. As I have mentioned before, this is what we called the clarification. The cloud centralizes the information sources, standardizes the implementation models and gives a holistic view of the environment and the security idea. The cloud can process information at volumes and a speed that we have never seen before, which allows the intelligence to increase the capacity of predicting threats, and it is the best way to facilitate a cyberspace that is safe and that allows each one of us to do our job in the best way possible, taking leverage of the others' job and giving customers the trust that we have discovered something all together. And this is regarding what I mentioned at first, which is that our goal is to give customers a platform where they can work better and reach much more. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you, and I hope that I can speak with you later.